Hello everyone, this is Ajinkya from final year CSE, and today I'm gonna be demonstrating the drone workings to you all that we have constructed using the raw materials that we procured. So the first thing that we had to do was assemble this frame right here, the one in white, red and black colors. As you can see, we have been supplied with the screws that were already in the kit. So as you can see the screws here, we have assembled it. The next thing we did was to install the motors using the screws provided by the motor kit. It was provided in the motor kit. So here we have affixed 4 screws in order to hold the motor in place. The next thing that we did was to install the ESCs right here. As you can see, the PL Heli ESC is there, 30 ampere. So the next thing that we did was to attach the ESC to the motor, and after that we attached the ESC's power supply into the input to the power distribution board that came along with the frame of the hexacopter. So as you can see, we have affixed all the motors and their ESCs in the similar manner. And right here, those blue terminals are the ones that come from power supply module, which takes its input from the battery. Now this will be connected. This is a XT60 connector, and our battery has the similar one right here. So this connector goes into this one, and this way our drone will get power, which will be distributed to the ESCs and the motors, and as well as the pixel. The series of black wires and the red wires you are seeing here is what supplies the power to Pixel. So I'll just flip this over right here. So as you can see, there is this arrow on our GPS module as well as on Pixel. This determines that which is the direction towards which our drone is facing. So right now our drone is facing in this particular direction. Now we have these motors and we have Pixel. So we set up Pixock using this particular technique, in where all those 6 pins that you are seeing here are the pins that come from the ESCs, which are connected in the main output of Pixock. The next thing we had to do was to connect the controller to the drone. Now we have the FlySky controller right over here. As you can see, the FS-I4 model, and we are receiving the input of this output of this particular transmitter as the input to this RC receiver right here, FS-6 model. So in order to supply 6 channel of input to this Pixock in one pin, we are using the PPM encoder. PPM encoder is connected with the RC receiver, and the output of PPM encoder will be connected with the Pixock's RC in. So that way Pixock will communicate with the RC transmitter right here. Along with that, we have here is a buzzer. Buzzer is very important because along with the LED right here, buzzer gives us important tunes regarding the status of the machine or the system. Next thing we have here is a switch. Now this particular switch is required to be pressed in order for the motors to start rotating. Until and unless this switch is pressed, the motors won't rotate. This is a mechanical failsafe for our drone. So after that, after the buzzer switch, right here is the telemetry and the GPS modules. So what you are seeing here is a telemetry antenna, and this is this particular is a air module of the telemetry kit. Now along with that, we are provided with this particular thing, which will be attached with USB to any desktop running Windows, Linux or Mac. Along with that, we can also attach this particular thing to a mobile phone using the OTG connector. So right here, the I2C cable is used for the additional compass that is provided with the GPS module. So we have 2 compasses, one in the Pixock and another one in the GPS module. After that, the only connection left is the power, which I displayed was on the back side. So let's go ahead and connect this battery with rest of the okay on the that.
So as you can see, as soon as I connected the battery here kept in between the chassis with the power of supply board, the drone started flashing various lights. So right now this is the power LED. This one is the activate or active LED, which displays that the pixock has been activated, and this green flashing LED indicates that the pixock is ready to be armed. Right now the pixock is unarmed but ready to be armed. Alright, now PPM encoder is flashing. Why? Because there is no RC input at this moment, and you can see that the RC receiver is flashing quickly in a like fast pace. Okay, right now our telemetry air module is also flashing green light. It means that it is searching for another radio signal, that is this one which we haven't yet connected with the computer yet. So GPS module, as you can see, it is already working. PPM encoder and receiver are searching for radio control, like remote transmitter signals, and the telemetry module is searching for its ground control signal. So after that, this is the arming LED. Now this one is searching for this is not searching for anything. As soon as we press it, our drone will be moved from unarmed to armed. When our drone will be armed, this green LED will change into a blue flashing LED. So right here we have our transmitter. So as you can see, the flashing has stopped, and it is a stable red LED indicating that the connection between transmitter and receiver is successful. And in this particular moment, the next thing I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be pressing the power button. So this was the SECs that made this sound. So in this particular state, our drone is ready for flight, and as soon as I press this particular button in this direction, the drone will arm itself and the propellers will start moving. So before that, we'll need to conduct some tests. For that, I'm gonna be adding the ground module to my laptop. So as you can see, there is a continuous green LED which indicates that the connection between air and ground modules has been made. So let us verify it from here. So as you can see, the LED which was earlier flashing green now is stable green. So right here, coming to the Ardu Pilot. Ardu Pilot is a software. This is the website of this particular Ardu Pilot software. As you can see, which is used for various RC based vehicles such as submarines, drones, and even planes and all. So this is the mission planner software that we are going to be using for our particular flight planning and other purposes. As you can see, here is a map of our country. In fact, this is a world map, and along with that we have the mission control here. As you can see, the drone is disarmed and the failsafe is activated. Along with that, the GPS doesn't have any fix in this particular moment. Now what we have to do is, here on Comfort 5 we are going to be attaching our hexacopter. So I'll just select the COM port, that is correct one, and I'll connect with our drone. So as you can see, it is trying to establish a Mavlink connection between the software, that is mission planner, and our drone. Now it is downloading some parameters from the pixock module to here. As you can see in the video, there is no physical connection between the drone and the mission planner. The only connection that is established is using the telemetry module.
as you can see now, everything is done and we are seeing a warning here which says that hardware safety switch is enabled. So right now what I'll do is I'll click on the button that is provided as a safety switch, and as soon as I click it, the warning will disappear. So as you can see, the warning has disappeared now, but the GPS still has no fix. This is the reason this is happening, because there are the GPS sensor we are using is of 7M, and there are various modules that are available in 12M, 18M and so on. So the greater the M number, the better reception is it has. So since we have less reception of GPS satellites, what we have to do is take the drone out outdoors so that it can have a better GPS fix. Next, we are going to be talking about the initial setup. As you can see here, first of all we installed the firmware from here. After that we installed the frame type, we calibrated the from here, this is our frame type, X type. After that we calibrated the accelerometer, we calibrated the compass. As you can see here, the offsets are in green, indicating that the compasses are calibrated. Then we calibrated our transmitter using the radio calibration, and as you can see here, the throttle is increasing and decreasing as I turn on and turn off the throttle machine throttle button. So similarly, all these buttons work. After that we also calibrated the electronic speed controllers using ESCs, that is ESCs. Afterwards we are going to run a motor test right here. So as you can see, in optional hardware here we have a motor test feature, and I am going to be reducing this percentage of throttle to 3% and duration to 1 second so that it doesn't consume much of our battery. And I'll run the motor test for motor A. So as you can see, this is the motor A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is E and this is F. So as soon as I test the motor A, it should start rotating. We also get the tunes from ESCs and the motor rotates successfully. Now I am going to be conducting the similar test for all motors, starting from motor A, B, C, D to E. I'll increase the throttle to 5% and duration to 2 seconds so that it is visible in the video. And I'll be pressing test all in sequence so that they rotate one by one. So the motor test is successful, as we have seen, and all the calibrations have been done. So in this particular moment, the drone is ready for flight.